everyone, welcome back to another tutorial, another week of painting. I hope you're all keeping very well and keeping very safe. This week I'm going to paint a lovely golf course for Anique. She is a very good follower, she's a patron, and she asked me could I paint this for her because she's kind of having trouble getting the greens right, that kind of thing. So I thought I'd paint this in a tutorial. I think you'll really like it. It's some lovely cool greens against some lovely warm greens as well, and there's lovely sun kind of catching some of the trees, so I think it's going to be really really fun. So let's try it this week, see how we go. If you're interested in Zoom lessons with me, one-to-one tutorials or a group, let me know, because they're getting really popular. We're having so much fun. We chat, we talk, drink tea, we paint, we have great fun and getting to know each other. So if you're interested, let me know, all right? It's very busy. They're getting really, really popular. So let me know with plenty of time in advance. If you're interested, try it. You might like it. Let's go and have a bit of fun with this. I can't wait to crack on and really get into this. It's going to be so much fun. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe, please. You're missing so much. I'll be right back. Okay, here we go. There's the photograph. Now, isn't that wonderful? You know, it kind of looks complicated with the perspective and stuff like that, but I think we can make it really lovely. Now, I'm going to do a quick sketch. Oh, by the way, I have a 16 by 12 canvas, primed once, and I will tell you what colours I have. I have titanium white, cobalt blue, lamp black, some burnt umber, cadmium yellow pale, some alizarin crimson, some Naples yellow, and burnt sienna. Now, I may need more white, because I do not think I have enough white in that. I'm going to need a decent amount of white. And I may also need a hint of phthalo blue, okay? A nice rich dark blue. I forgot those. So a tiny amount of blue just there, look. So a nice all-round kind of a palette, a nice warm palette. Now, let's do a quick sketch, just a very rough sketch. I'm going to go along where the end of the golfing green is there, all right? Let's see, about this much up. Okay. Then it kind of takes a rise there, doesn't it? We have a lovely line of trees coming along like that, roughly. I'm going to just suggest the line of trees. Then I'm going to suggest another line of trees off in the distance like that. You see, it's just very, very loose. Excuse me. And then I'm going to put in the footpath. It kind of takes a turn, comes down like that. Now, in the original photograph that I got, there was a bit of a lake here with a little bit of a reflection showing, but it just did not help the photograph because there was only a tiny amount of reflection showing. So I just kind of zoomed in very slightly on the photograph, only just a little bit, because it wasn't really seen. You couldn't really see the reflections that much. So I thought I'd zoom in and just focus on the trees with the golfing green going up the course. So yeah, you know, it's, you have to kind of make a decision sometimes and say, okay, do I leave it in or do I take it out? That was just a decision I made. Now, there we go. Lots of big trees coming up here like that. I think that's enough. That's all we need. Large stubby brush. I put some tape around it because it was getting a little tiny bit loose, so I just put some tape around it. You know, I get another couple of months out of it. I was probably pressing on it too hard at some stage, or even when I was cleaning on the tissue, I might have pressed it too hard, and it just kind of loosened the ferrule a tiny, tiny bit, but it'll be fine. Now, a nice bright blue sky. Let's take some cobalt blue with a tiny amount of thinners, okay, and plenty of white. Cobalt blue is a very forgiving colour. It's very soft. You can do so much with cobalt blue. It's really beautiful. Little more thinners. I just want to thin this so it's like a nice thick kind of a creamy colour. Do you understand? Now, okay, you can see everything okay there. Let me see now, is that okay? Oh, that's not bad. I'm trying not to use too much of the darker blue in this because I don't want to overpower the painting. I want to keep the sky nice and bright, fresh, blue kind of a colour. You know what I mean? Now, just go along like that across the sky. Just drag your paint across the canvas. And my mix is quite on the thin side, only because I perhaps should have given my canvas an extra prime of undercoat. So it's kind of a little bit on the dry side, but not very, very dry, do you know what I mean? But it is kind of soaking up the paint just a little. So I'm going to mix a decent amount of paint here now, all right? So I start then by putting on thin layers and working in thicker colour on top. That's generally how I like to kind of paint my skies. So I'm just flicking this across now. Whichever way you like, just to kind of fill that in. I'll take some more cobalt blue, actually. That's quite a nice colour, the cobalt, isn't it? It's a beautiful colour. And let's take more thinners now. Lots more cobalt. I want this nice and thin so it moves around. The thing about it is when you add white into the mix, it sort of thickens up very quickly again. So then I need to pick up more thinners. So when I'm taking more white, I take a little more thinners with it, just to make that nice and thin, you see? And it goes across lovely on the canvas then. And another thing I'm going to do is, as it comes down further and further, it's going to get much, much brighter. So I'm just going to pick up lots of white, okay? With a little drop of thinners again, and go right on there and blend that right across. You get a nice light colour off in the distance in the sky. And then I'll soften it up, okay? Now, I'll clean my brush very quickly so I can pick up some nice fresh white. I'll put some nice bright white in there, just covering some of the tree line, not all of it. So now, we have a nice gradient there, don't we? Going from dark down to light. And you see, another thing about this is, you need to kind of think in advance, because we've lovely bright white clouds, so you want to put a nice decent kind of a blue sky in there. You don't want to put something that's too pale and too soft, because the white clouds won't jump out. They'll just get lost. So I'm going to put an extra little bit of cobalt blue just along the top, and I'm going to soften that down just a little, all right? Because I feel it needs to be that little bit darker, just a little, only a little. I hope you enjoy these tutorials, by the way. I do my best to try and kind of keep them as informative as I can. You know, I say it every single week, I like to give you a really good tutorial, because I think you deserve it. You know, you're trying to learn how to paint and you need all the help you can get, all the advice, and I think every little thing helps. So I like to really give a quality tutorial. Now, I'm happy enough with that, okay? Let's just leave it at that. I'm going to move to a smaller brush. I go to a slightly smaller size. Let me see now. Let's have a look around here now and see what we have. Okay, I go to this nice small kind of a flat brush. It's like a medium stubby, okay? I have a medium stubby here, but it's very wide. Look, it's very kind of widely splayed. This will be perfect now for our trees in a moment. Let me get my brushes. I dropped a couple of brushes there. Now, so let's take something like a medium stubby, a number 12 flat. It's kind of slightly worn, all right? Now, I'm going to dampen that. I'm going to get more thinners, and I'm going to take that brush and let's dampen very gently there, give it a good dry. Let's go right into some bright color. Now I'm going to mix a nice bright color for a cloud. I'm not going to use pure white, because the sun is kind of going down in the sky and it's kind of a very warm color. I'll take a little Naples yellow, and I'm going to take a hint of crimson, okay? Now I'm only mixing a tiny amount of this. Look, you don't need to mix huge amounts on your palette. Just a nice small little amount, just there. Naples yellow and crimson. But I have more crimson. It's not very, very yellow, okay? It's more pinky, but it's like a salmon kind of a colour. a very pale salmon colour. And with that, let's just dab a little bit of that on there. Very, very loosely. Now, it may be still a little bit on the yellow side, so I'll take a tiny amount of crimson again, and more white. And another tiny amount of Naples yellow. The Naples yellow is really only just to warm it very, very slightly, if you understand. And I'll put another one up there like this. I'll put a hint of that lovely warm colour up here. I'll put one or two kind of floating across like that. Okay, clean it again, because each time I'm doing this, I'm picking up blue from the canvas. So I want to keep the brush nice and clean, you see. So I'll go back in now and mix another tiny amount of that. That colour. Lots of white. And I'll go over here and do another one. Like that, okay. So these now are the lights. Then I'm going to move to the darks. So I'm just going to give this a slight clean. Let me just find this now. There we go. And I'm going to use this. I'm going to take some cobalt blue. I'm going to take a hint of crimson. Okay, I'll take a touch of white. Now I want a bit more crimson in this, and I'm going to add a tiny amount of burnt umber. That burnt umber now is going to warm this really nice and give us a lovely shadow for a cloud, because it's not bluey purple, it's like a warm brown kind of a mauve. Okay, let's just try it and see. Let's go to the center one here. So you can see now how these two colors are really, really kind of bouncing off each other. Let me just kind of soften it out, just a little here and there. And then I'll put a couple of little flicks around here and there, underneath. I'll put some around here. So the light in this painting is coming from the left-hand side, okay? So I keep all the shadow clouds on the right-hand side of these lights. So just like this, look. Okay, does that make sense? And put a couple over here. I'm going to make this a nice big one over here. I'm just kind of playing around with the brush, leaving it sort of dance around itself on the canvas. I'm going to put one or two up under these. Okay. And I might just pop one or two. They're primarily kind of off in the distance, really, aren't they? A hint of black. Tiny, tiny hint of cobalt blue. And I'll just darken them gently, just a little bit here and there. Now, so I'm going to stop at that, and I'm going to soften them together very gently with my wife's makeup brush. I won't say nothing if you don't, okay? Let's just soften them, and I'm kind of flicking it very gently, look. I'm giving it a little flick like this. Now, we will brighten some of our lights again, okay? So don't worry about some of those. We'll go horizontal at the horizon. And soften some of these in up there. And go here and soften some of that. So now we have nice, gentle kind of cloud swooping across our sky. But I'm not finished yet. I'm then going to take a nice, small, kind of a round-ish brush. And I'm going to mix up some of that colour, which I just mixed, okay? So some Naples yellow, crimson. Now that's a bit much. Lots of white. Lots and lots and lots and lots of white. Little more Naples. So nice thick paint on this now. And I'm going to pop this real bright colour here and there. Just where I feel that sun is catching the cloud. Maybe a little around there. Okay. I'll pop some around here, look. So it's kind of on, sort of on the left hand side of the cloud, if you understand what I mean. I'll pop some through here. And I'm just kind of going around in small little circles. That's all I'm doing. I'm softening it back into the darker colour then. So let me show you. I'll bring another one down here in front and I'll soften it back into that darker colour. Little circles, just let that kind of disappear. So now we're getting some nice little effects, aren't we? Isn't that wonderful? Let's put a couple in here. Maybe down at the base, put one or two across the tops. Just skimming across the tops of those. And put one or two out here. Just kind of darting across the sky over there, look. Like that. And I think we just need to keep it simple like this. I think that's probably enough. You know, we don't have to go to extreme details in this painting. I'm happy enough with that. Okay, moving along. Moving along, let's go and get our medium stubby. Now I'll use this just for the darker colour, okay? I'm going to put in a nice dark colour on this here. A nice dark colour of a green is black and yellow, okay? Let's just try that. Black and yellow, and we have a nice medium kind of a green. It's not really, really dark. It's like a very dark olive kind of a green, all right? Now, let me just pop that in there. I'm going to just pick out very quickly, because it's just a tutorial now. I'm not copying the painting exactly. And you can kind of really copy these shape of these trees if you want to. Do them exactly the same. But I'm just kind of showing you how I approach a scene like this. Let's make that one a nice round one there. And then it goes down and disappears. So I have a nice base colour in there now, don't I, for these trees. I'll bring it across, look. Let's go right across, just a little. All right, now, that's that. We have a very dark section over here, so I'm going to take some black and a hint of phthalo, all right? Because you can see it's quite cool. There's a very, very dark, cool blue down over here. Well, a bluey kind of a green, do you understand? Take a touch of black down in there. So what we end up with then is a very, very dark line down here against the very bright green of the golf course. So I'm put that nice dark across there, put a little bit there. I'm just sort of flicking it up upwards, gently kind of softening it up into the trees. I'll put a hint of more blue in around here because there's a lovely cool kind of shades in this. Put just one or two, okay? Now, I'll leave it at that. I'm happy enough. I'll put this down. I'll keep this now because there's green paint on this. It would be almost impossible for me to get this colour out completely, so I'll keep this for the rest of my trees. All right, so put that down. Now I'm going to move to another brush. It's another simple flat brush, slightly worn, okay? Now this one is not really badly worn. It's just a little, you see it? It's just starting to fill up. This is perfect now for my next step, for the lights on these trees. And let's have a bit of fun. I'm going to take with a dry brush because this is already wet. So a dry brush, I'm going to take lots of yellow, and I may take a hint of burnt sienna. Very, very, very small amount now, okay? Now, that might even be okay for me because you have to think, right? What's going to happen is when I start putting this colour on, it's going to start softening into that green that's already there. So we're going to end up with different shades of green. It's not going to be this colour all the way through. I'll start now with the very bright side. So this, again, the sun is coming from the left. It's going to catch the trees on the left-hand side. So here, you see a big one here? Let's try it. Let's just go at a slight angle. Look at that now. I'm going to soften that down. There we go. Very gently, just with the corner of the brush, okay? And I'm going to let that then very gently disappear into the darks down there. Look. Hardly touching the canvas. Now, how was that? Now, how simple was that? a simple bushy tree. Isn't that just wonderful? You see, I tell you something, you're missing so much on this channel. You have to tune in, subscribe, watch. You learn new things every time. Let's put a hint up here. I'm turning the brush slightly to give the direction of that foliage, kind of falling down almost. I'm going to leave the dark. I like that. And this is only the first step, okay? We will put extra lights on this as well as we're going. So let's take some more of that yellow. We could even take a hint of Naples yellow if you want. Now I picked up a little bit of the green, okay? You can see it. So it's just a nice bright green. Let's go here. And turn the brush down. You see, we're creating lots of different types of bushes, lots of separate bushes. Now let me clean that again. And I'm going to pick up some Naples yellow with a hint of sienna for a change. Let's try a bit of sienna. The sienna will really warm this up. Let's go here. So now we have a slightly warmer green. And we put another one underneath it. Look, another little bush. So now we have lots of different separate kind of trees, don't we? Isn't this great fun? I love painting trees like this. It's just so simple, yet it's so dramatic. It really, really is. You should try it. It's just using old worn brushes, okay? You don't need expensive fancy brushes for this. You know, people try and sell you lots of expensive fancy brushes. You don't need them. Any old brush that you have will do just fine for this. Now, we just soften that one down. And the nice thing about this is that you get different types of effects every time you use the brush, depending on which way the hairs are, you know what I mean? So now we have another one. Look, that's nice, I like that. That's nice, I like that one. I'm going to pick up some yellow on its own, with a hint of crimson. Put that nice bright colour over there. And I'm just going to kind of let this soften away because, now, next, I'm going to take some cadmium yellow with a hint of white. I'm mixing all this now, look, in the same place on the same brush. And let's really get some light onto this. So the sun is coming down. Look, it's catching there. Catching along here. Okay. We're creating a kind of a line coming down where the sun is catching, all right? So I'm going to stop in exactly the same place. So imagine the line is coming up like this, okay? Maybe another bit there. There we go. Now I'll soften this one out just gently because it's a little bit on the harsh side. And I'm happy enough with that. Let's stick a touch of sienna in there because we'll have trees with a little sienna as well, just to break it up a little, yes? And also, with a very small pointy brush, let's pop in some tree trunks using that very same yellow. How easy is this? Okay, done. I think we're done with that side. Right, what will we do next? Will we concentrate on some of this side here? Try and get that done. Yes? Come on, let's do it. I'm going to use the same brush because I like this brush. First of all, now I'm going to just put a nice dark area in with this wide, rough kind of brush. So phthalo blue, a bit of green. Let's go for a bit of burnt umber actually as well in this. Phthalo blue again. I'm going to fill this area in just with that dark colour, alright? You see, I like to kind of fill areas in. I'll take a touch of white as it comes out. So you can see now, it's lightening, maybe a hint of yellow. I want a nice light kind of a pale green for this. Okay, as it comes down. I may continue that colour as it's on there, it's quite nice for the golf course look. A little bit more white, and there's a lot more white and a lot more blue in this as it comes over to this side, you see? Then it goes up like that. So already we have our lovely golf course colour. Now we can work on this, but I just want to get this all kind of in here, a little bit more blue and a hint of crimson. That will give me a nice soft mauvey colour for down here. And I create that bank kind of turning down there, okay? There we go. Okay, nice and simple. Nice and simple. No panic whatsoever. Let's get a nice green and do a big green tree there. There's a lovely green tree I can see. I'll take a hint of black and a hint of cadmium yellow. And I'm going to make this nice and rich because it'll stand out lovely against these trees. So you can see it's like, I'm just going to go like that. Let's take a hint maybe of brown, a little bit of burnt umber in that. As it comes up, it just gets a little bit thinner, doesn't it? You can see I'm just dabbing the brush, that's all. Okay. We have a nice dark one that comes in up here. I'm going to put that in. And again, nice and simple. Some black, little burnt umber, perhaps a little phthalo blue. The phthalo blue will just darken it up a little bit and make it cool at the same time. More black. Let's go up here and get that in. Now, you could use a palette knife for this as well if you want. Palette knife would be nice. It's just a very random sort of a tree, isn't it? I'll try a hint of burnt sienna and burnt umber as well. I lighten it just ever so slightly. Then it comes down, it gets very dark. I need more black. Let me get more black on my palette here. So we're having fun, yes? Lots and lots of fun. Take some black into that and fill this area in. It's very dark down here now, isn't it? It just gets very dark. See? Soften it in. Okay. We can darken this up with our palette knife in a minute. Alright, let's go right down here now. Get some nice proper dark colour in down here. I'm just filling it in, alright? I'm not worried about shape or direction or anything like that just yet. Okay, now. Give that brush a little clean. And I'm going to start putting in some of my slightly lighter trees down there. I'll take some yellow, some burnt sienna, cadmium yellow that is, and I'm going to just suggest one or two little trees here and there. I take some sienna with Naples yellow, and I suggest one or two of the tops of the trees. Okay, that. Then I'm going to take my pointy brush and put in some nice tree trunks. Again, keeping this nice and simple. Take some Naples yellow and go right up here with a tall one. I'll put in that nice tree now that's just there because we kind of lost it there, didn't we? So I'll put a little bit of a one in here. Let's take a hint of yellow on its own. There we are, look at that. That's better now, isn't it? No, some cadmium yellow down here. And let's suggest this little bush coming up like that. All right, now I'm going to put a nice cool one, a nice cool bush in, using cobalt blue with white and a little yellow. And I'm going to put a nice, that nice round kind of a bush in just there. Okay. Let me put another one. Perhaps just next to it here. See what I mean? It's just a nice little suggestion, that's all, of little bushes and things going on. Now, I'm going to bring this colour right down. I'm going to mix a nice colour from that. It's a nice cool colour. A cool blue really is just, you could use either cobalt or phthalo. Let's try cobalt blue. Let's take a little Naples yellow and a little cadmium yellow. Now you can keep working this until you have the colour that you want, all right? Now let's try that. That's not bad, is it? I might take a hint of white just to lighten it very slightly, and a hint more of Naples yellow. So we have a nice cool blue there now. Soften that up here. Take a little more cobalt. Now I'm going to add a hint of a kind of a mauve into this, right? Only a hint. And what I mean is, I'm going to take some cobalt blue, a tiny touch of crimson. I'm going to add that little touch of mauve, kind of a blue, just into the green here and there. And that colour will give you a lot of distance as well. You see? So a little bit of mauve and a little bit of white. And I'm going to pop a little touch of that in just here and there. Look. And you see that then really pushes the green off into the distance, doesn't it? Let's get a touch more pink in that. Pop a bit of colour in here and there. Look, see? There's a nice blast of colour now for you. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? And I may make it slightly richer as it comes down. Just because as it's coming closer to you, it's going to get slightly richer. Only just. Okay? Only just a little. Let's take more phthalo, a hint of crimson, and some yellow. The yellow will warm it. Just that little bit. There now. That's better, isn't it? And I'll bring that right down. Let's just fill in the bottom of this canvas with that colour. Now, so there we go. The next step I'm going to do is, now I'm wondering, should I lighten it very slightly up at the top? I'm going to take a smaller flat brush, okay? Just like this, something like that, okay? And I won't thin it. I'll take a little bit of white, a little Naples yellow, and just with that I may just put in a hint. You know what, no, I'll take a hint of cadmium yellow. Look, I may just put a hint of light, kind of a greeny color, catching it just here and there. Look, and it's just to create a bit of texture on the fairway. See, look, just a touch. Just a slight little touch coming down. I think it helps give it something. Now we have a footpath here. I don't want to lose the footpath, so I'm putting that in. I will take, again, my small round brush. I'm going to go for a nice purpley kind of a colour. Let's get some pink and some blue. A little white. And notice all these colours have a hint of a green in them as well, you see? I'm mixing them wherever there's a bit of green, because that little touch of green will pick it up and really help. Now let's go like that. You see? Nice and simple. A simple little curve. And I'll just let that disappear in there, look. How about that? And then I put a hint of dark colour just around one lip of, just around the edge of this, just here and there, look. Just to give the edge of the grass. Do you understand? It just helps give it a bit of something. It just really does. Now I'll soften this edge down as well. How about that? Isn't that lovely? Let's move on to our trees up here. Because this is the side that really brings the painting to life, isn't it? Let me get more white. And what do I need? I think I have enough brown, I have enough blue. I think we should be okay. I'm going to start with, let me see. I might get a flat brush. I'm going to take a flat synthetic brush like this, okay, for these trees. And I may just put a warm color in there first. So I may take some yellow, mix it into this green here, and take a hint of burnt sienna, and I may use that color just to fill this area in, okay? So I'm using a warm base now this time, instead of using a rich dark base. And I can add darks then into this because I want to keep the luminous kind of effect on some of these trees. I'm just putting in the kind of main bulk area of the trees. Now, I'm going to start putting some darks in because there's some darks down here, isn't there? So I start adding some darks now with phthalo blue, a little burnt umber, that'll just warm it slightly. You can see this is very thin turpentine kind of paint. It's really thin. But I'm just taking care. I don't want to overdo it with too much paint too earlier on. So I'm being very, very careful. Now I'll take a little black and a little blue. And we have a real dark section down here. And just kind of putting that in like that. Little touch here and there. Okay. So now we have the darks done. The next thing I will do is, let me think about this now for a moment. I can see a couple of nice browns in around here. So I'm going to put a hint of some browns in, suggest some of the trees. Nice one here. Perhaps sienna. Okay. This will all make sense very soon, I promise. We have a nice sienna kind of a tree there. Okay. And I think that will do for now. So the next step now is to start putting some nice bright lights on this. And I'm using this flat brush so that it's going to kind of almost come to a point when I put a paint on this, all right? So let me show you. We have a couple of nice little green trees up there. So let's make a nice green for this. Cadmium yellow. A little touch of burnt umber, I think that will give us a warm green. Now let me try that. I'm putting lots of paint on the tip of my brush, look. And let me just try and see if we can create some nice little trees up there. You see? Just like that. You can add darker colours to these then. So let's put a little bit of shade here and there on some of these. Especially as they come down. I have a lovely bright coloured, it's like a pinky sienna kind of a colour there. I'll take burnt sienna with some Naples yellow and a hint of crimson. Now this is going to look nice, I hope. Little cadmium yellow. And I think a bit more crimson. Let's put this nice one in. That. Now, I am going to use my palette knife as well very soon to get some of these trees more prominent and get some really nice rich colour on some of these because I think it needs that nice rich colour. Some crimson again, some sienna. Pop some of that in there. I may put some in here actually as well. There's some nice, lots of nice trees around here. I'm just going to spread out the colour a little bit. Again, you don't have to copy everything exactly. Let me see, have I a slightly smaller brush for this? Okay. No, I stick with the same one, I think. Now, I'm going to go with a nice dark green further up the canvas. So I'm making a very nice dark green here. Black, blue, little yellow, little burnt umber. I'm going to go right up here with one just like that, okay? Take some black, take some yellow, give that some really nice darks. Painting trees is tricky, but you don't have to paint them exactly the same, okay? Just make them your own. Take some black, blue and brown. I'm going to get some nice dark ones in down here. Just to get that side covered in. Let's go right down here with some nice dark colour. Okay. Now let me clean that. And I may go and try. Let me see what other kind of brushes we have here. I have another smaller brush. I might try this. I'm going to go right into some cadmium yellow, some Naples yellow, and I'm going to go up here and add a touch of light onto that tree, just here and there, okay? Like that. And I'm going to go back into that again. I'll add a nice light tree in here. I think the trick with this is not to put too much paint on too soon. Do you agree? Because if you put too much paint on, it gets very, very messy. And the paint just will not stick. So just be careful not to put too much thick paint on very, very early on in the painting. We take some cadmium yellow and some bonsai henna. And I'll take plenty of white. This will give us a nice bright colour, and I'm going to pop some of that in just here and there, look. Okay. And let's put a couple of nice lights up here, these trees. I could take some yellow on its own and just soften some down here and there. I just want to keep some of the darks, you see. I'm not going too far into those darks. I want to keep those because they're very nice. Okay. Now, I'll take a small pointy brush and put a hint of a few tree trunks in with some Naples yellow. So just a couple. Okay. I'll put one or two here. And I may take some burnt umber and put a hint of a couple up there with some darker colour. It's just a suggestion, really. Now, I want to create that lovely light coming down, okay? Now, this is the fun part. Take some cadmium yellow and I'm going to take a hint of burnt sienna just to warm it slightly. And then a nice bit of white, okay? Now, a good bit of white in this. And I'm going to use this lovely rich colour. I'm going to pull downwards like this, okay? So now, we're getting that nice light coming down, aren't we? And then it's going to soften away as it comes down here. Now I'm going to pull this across and soften that in. My finger, look, just like that. And then pull these across. I know on the photograph, they're very kind of sharp-edged. They really kind of stand out prominently. But I think just by pulling them down, just simply like this, and softening them across, that and I'm going to soften them upwards. Okay. Now we'll fix our trees, don't worry about the trees. Now, how are we looking here? So I'm just going to fix some of my trees now with this brush. We get some bonsai in it with this one here. And I'll take some dark green and fix some of these here. And we could, if you wanted to, I'll take another small flat brush, okay? And I'm going to just lighten slightly. Just lighten one or two of these very slightly. Okay, let me take a look at this now and see how that's all looking. I'm going to soften some of this up here. Now, I think we need a lot more yellow in this. Loads more yellow and a bit more of the cyan. I think this needs to be really looked at. I think that's better now, is it? I think it really wants to be seen, doesn't it? And then I'm going to take some dark, okay? I'm going to take some dark color now next. Plenty of blue, and I'll take a hint of Naples yellow, because what I want to do is create some dark. Do you know what the lighter green is on the fair, on the fair, the God fair? I want to create some dark just by that. So I'm getting a dark color, but it's kind of a soft pasty kind of a color, and I'm going to go up here and just sort of pull it down like this, you see. Soften it over. Then I'll take a smaller brush and I might just refine some of the edges on that, okay? Just a touch. Because I think on the photograph they look a lot more prominent, don't they? Yeah. Now, while doing that as well, I'm going to very gently soften them. I think they should be just softened very gently together, okay? Because I want to create the effect that the grass is really smooth. It is a golf course after all, so I want to create the effect that the grass is really, really smooth up there. And then I'm going to just tap in some extra little trees with my little flat brush here. Some cadmium yellow and some white. And I'm going to tap in one or two in front of that grass. Look, just to kind of make it pop a little bit. Okay. And perhaps one or two splashes of yellow up here. Then a little burnt sienna, and I might just make that one a little bit more. Just there. How are we looking so far? That is not bad. Now let's have a look around and see. Take some cadmium yellow with burnt sienna and a little Naples yellow, and you're going to add a little light to this on top. I will add some light to some of the trees up high because they will catch the sun a little bit more. Okay, I'll do a bit over there. Perhaps create some little bushes down at the end. How about that? Let's try that. Okay, create some bushes. Some blue, some black. We have plenty of blue in this. Go along with this now first. Okay, that's like this. I need phthalo blue. Just a little. To get this nice dark colour in down here. There we go, little phthalo blue, little black. We'll pull that colour across there first like that. Okay, I'll take a little burnt umber. Alright, now, then what I'm going to do is, I think I'll try my fan brush. I'll take a small fan brush, I'll dampen it slightly. Some cadmium yellow into the blue, a little bit of that white, but it's in the shadow, so I'm going to keep it cool still, so a little bit blue in that. Okay, now I'm just going to go along and just create some kind of a bushy area just along the front here. Okay, and I lighten it slightly. A little more white. Okay. Let's take some of that white with a little yellow, and we could pop a little, a couple of little bits and pieces in. Let's try a little bit of the, it could be kind of a greenery area with little flowers and stuff like that planted. Just to keep it simple like this, okay? One last thing I must do. I must pop a bird in. A small wee little bird up at the corner, and I'm happy enough with this as a little demonstration. I think, it's all we need just to kind of show off. I suppose it's all about kind of the light, the way the light is hitting. I might take a little Naples yellow and pop a little Naples yellow in just here and there on that. There it is. Pop a little touch of it in up here. Just to refine some of those. Okay. I am happy with that, my friends. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me zoom in. I hope, Anik, I've made this a little bit easier for you to kind of try yourself. But in general, I'm happy with that. Look, it's just about the light catching the trees. That's all. That's really all we're concentrating on. Lovely clouds. Nice, simple clouds. Yeah. Nice, simple trees. I really like those trees off in the distance. I'm very happy with those. Aren't they just wonderful? So just keep it nice and simple, that's all. There we go. I hope you enjoyed that. Let me fix this thing down. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back next week with another tutorial. I'm not sure yet, perhaps a nice snow scene. I'm concentrating on Christmas. Christmas is coming and I want to cheer people up with some snow scenes. Okay, I will see. Let me know what you think. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back very soon with another tutorial. Happy painting, my friends, and thank you so much for your support. And God bless you all. Take care and bye bye.